फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। आ केयरफुल एनालिसिस ऑफ सब सेक्शन थ्री वुड मेक इट क्लियर दैट द फर्स्ट पार्ट विच रिक्वायर्स द डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट टू कन्वेन मीटिंग ऑफ द बोर्ड फॉर कंसिडरिंग द मोशन ऑफ नो कॉन्फिडेंस अगेंस्ट द प्रेसिडेंट इज मैंडेटरी। द डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू परफॉर्म अ पब्लिक ड्यूटी इन कन्वेनिंग अ मीटिंग ऑफ द बोर्ड फॉर कंसिडरेशन ऑफ द मोशन एट द ऑफिस ऑफ द बोर्ड ऑन द डेट एंड टाइम एज फिक्स्ड बाय हिम। ही हैज नो चॉइस इन द मैटर। ही हैज टू कन्वेन अ मीटिंग ऑन अ डेट विद इन 30 and 35 डेज फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द मोशन टू हिम। The district magistrate is further enjoined to perform a public duty of sailing notice of the meeting to the members. This again is a mandatory requirement of law which must be strictly complied with. The second part of the subsection lays down the manner required to be followed in sending notices to the members. It lays down that notice of the meeting shall be sent by registered post to every member of the board at his place of residence. The essence of this provision is to give information to the members to enable them to avail opportunity of participating in the meeting convened for the purpose of considering the no confidence motion. The first part of the section requiring the district magistrate to convene meeting and to send notices to the members is mandatory. Any disregard of that provision would defeat the very purpose of the meeting, but the manner of service of notice and publication of the same is directory in nature. The purpose of service of notice by registered post and publication of the notice otherwise is to ensure that members should get adequate notice of the meeting to enable them to participate in the debate over the no confidence motion at the meeting. That purpose is not defeated if the notice is sent to the members not by registered post but by other methods, and 7 clear days are given to the members. The legislature never intended that unless notice is sent by registered post to the members, the proceedings of the meeting would be vitiated. The legislature no doubt stressed that if the two steps as laid down in the subsection are taken by the district magistrate, that is, notice of the meeting is sent to members by registered post at their place of residence, and further, if it is published in the manner directed by the district magistrate, a presumption would arise and every member shall be deemed to have received the notice of the meeting. In that case, it will not be open to any member to contend that he did not receive notice of the meeting or that the meeting was illegally constituted for want of notice. The purpose of sending notice can be achieved even without sending the same by registered post. There may be a case where the postal system may be disorganized and it may not be possible to send notice by registered post. In that situation, the district magistrate may send a notice to members of the board by special messenger, giving them 7 clear days before the date of the meeting. In that event, the legislative intent and purpose requiring sending of notice would be fully achieved, although in that event the rule of presumption as laid down in the subsection would not be available, and if a challenge was made by a member that no notice was received by him, the deeming provision will not be applicable and it would require proof that the notice, even though sent by ordinary post or by special messenger, was actually served on the member. The emphasis on sending notice to members by registered post and for publication of the same in the manner directed by the district magistrate is directed to invoke the presumption as contemplated in the last sentence of the subsection.